Chicos, muchas gracias por estar con nosotros aquí en Centroamérica. Para la gente que apenas va a empezar a disfrutar de los contenidos de Starz, cuéntenos qué es Pennyworth.
So Pennyworth is the story, the origin story of the famous butler and sort of guardian of Batman, Alfred Pennyworth. And in this version, we meet Alfred at the age of 26. He's just out of the army that he's been in for 10 years, and he's thrust into this civilian world, which is London in the 1960s, but not London as was or as we know it. It's a DC Comics version of London, which we always thought of as 13 degrees weirder and darker and more twisted version of London. And he's trying to step away from violence, from the army, settle down, build a nice business so he can have kids and kind of keep his head down. But this dangerous version of London has other ideas, especially when he meets Thomas Wayne, who kind of is. Do you want to talk about him? You
No.
should talk about
Es una gran responsabilidad porque cronológicamente es el primer vistazo al universo completo de Batman.
Yeah, absolutely. It's quite daunting. I think we've gone the furthest back. So technically, everything follows on from us if you think of it chronologically. So yeah, it's definitely a big undertaking, which we've sort of realized after shooting it, didn't we? We're
Yeah, it
like,
was probably
oh.
quite helpful that we weren't putting too much pressure, I don't think. But it's really exciting, I think, to they've created a new world that doesn't even exist in the comic books in Pennyworth, in that we're in London in the 1960s, but it's an alternative version of London as well, which is kind of more fantastical and weirder and darker and more twisted, like Jack was saying. So yeah, it's very exciting for that reason.
¿Cómo llegó este proyecto a las manos de cada uno de ustedes? ¿Cómo fue cuando se enteraron que iban a tener estos papeles?
Oh, it was amazing. I mean, I, like anything else, my agent emailed me and I read the summary of the show and thought, okay, fair enough, and I'm slightly unsure. But as soon as I read the script, I was hooked. And then I set about on one of the longest audition processes of my life. I think I had eight auditions, and I was offered the job. Then it was taken away. It was all very confusing. But ultimately, when I got it, it was sort of relief, and then the excitement followed. But originally, it was just like, thank God that's over, you know.
How much for you?
Yeah, similar thing. So I didn't know much about it until reading the script and kind of got to page three and read about the world that he was setting it in, this version of London, and that was very exciting. And then I had a slightly easier time of it than Jack, just 'cause I think they weren't as fussy with who they got to play Thomas. But not such a long process, but I was very excited to be working on it, and I think it's a great character. So yeah, it was just I was ready to get started and enjoyed up doing it all.
¿Y ustedes crecieron como seguidores de este universo o es como su primer encuentro con todo lo que tiene que ver con DC Comics?
I think neither of us were comic readers, but like I know that I was very aware of Batman growing up. I guess you can't not be really. He's kind of very, ever present. And my introduction to him really was the Tim Burton films. So yeah, I've not. I've now looked at the comics. Now we're doing this, but I didn't grow up reading them necessarily.
Same for me, really. Yeah.
Yeah.
El primer episodio que vimos hace unos días, vemos como que precisamente Alfred trata como de reivindicar su vida después de estar en el ejército. Entonces, es parte de ese camino que vamos a ver hasta que llegue a la vida glamorosa que tenía ya siendo el mayordomo de Batman.
Yeah, I think this is very much a story of him in London and it kind of not being that glamorous. I think even by the end of this series, he's kind of got himself together a little bit more. I don't think that's a spoiler, but he's a long way from the billionaire kind of employee, glossy sort of Gotham lifestyle. It's very much this dark London that he still frequents.
Bueno, para el caso tuyo, Benjamin, ¿cómo fue también estar en la piel del padre de Batman?
Yeah, I guess quite exciting, really. I didn't really realize the magnitude of it. I knew that it was a very exciting project, and I was very pleased to be playing it, but it kind of hit home when I was on set. There's this club. Is it called the Velvet Rope?
No. Scarlet Rope.
Scarlet Rope, the Scarlet Rope, which is one of our sets. One of our sets of this brilliant club that they built that we have lots of scenes in together. I was just about to get ready to do a take and was chatting to this background artist, just having like a normal, normal conversation. And then when we finished chatting, he turned to the other background artist and he was like, "Oh my goodness, I've just been talking to Thomas Wayne, Batman's dad." And I was like, "I don't know." And I was like, "Oh, people may be really excited to meet this character because they've never known about him much before." So, yeah, I guess I was just excited to discover him and find out who he was, and yeah, it was cool.
Se nos están acabando los minutos, pero me gustaría que le hicieran una invitación a la audiencia de Centroamérica a disfrutar de Pennyworth ahora que tienen Stars Play disponible.
Yes. Hello, Central America. My name is Ben Aldridge, and I'm playing Thomas Wayne in Pennyworth.
My name's Jack Bannon, and I play Alfred Pennyworth in Pennyworth.
And we're very excited to be sharing Pennyworth with you on Stars Play on the 25th of October, so make sure you watch it.